Sharon in South Dakota asked a question that came in this morning. Did God create evil? And let's just check this in the passage. This came in through a tweet, and it's Isaiah chapter 45, verse 7. Is the question. And the scripture speaking, God is speaking. He says, I form the light and create darkness. I make peace and create evil. I, the Lord, do these things. Now, it is, of course, a great question. It says right there, I make peace and create evil. Let me give a cross-reference here, Amos chapter 3, verse 6, it says, if a trumpet is blown in a city, will not the people tremble? If a calamity incurs in the city, has not the Lord done it? So, I create evil, or in Amos 3, 6, I bring about calamity. Now, one of the things when we consider this, of course, God in the New Testament, it says he is not the author of temptation, and we know that God is perfectly holy. And so how do you have a God who creates evil? In the Young's Literal Translation, I'm just noticing here, it says, forming light and preparing darkness, making peace and preparing evil. So preparing is perhaps a little different word. Let's check the Strong's Concordance and see what it says about the word evil. It seems to be a word that is translated in various ways. It's very often used, 664 times actually in the Bible, that particular Hebrew word for evil is used. But it is sometimes translated even as sorrow or as mischief, as harm. And evil favoredness, quite a few translations here, 442 times as wickedness. I think, let's look at the word create here. And I believe that what we're going to find here is that, we have the particular word for create is just the typical. It's the typical word for create. In fact, let's go on down to verse 8, Isaiah 45:8. Drop down, ye heavens, from above, and let skies pour down righteousness. Let the earth open, and let them bring forth salvation. Let righteousness spring up together. I, the Lord, have created it. Same word in verse 8 as in verse 7 of Isaiah chapter 45. Now, I think that what this says is, you know, there is the sense in which God created everything that is. And yet, I think that, and this is where I would disagree with, say, the Calvinists, I'm not a fatalist that says God creates the car wreck or God creates the murderer. The murderer he created, but did he create the murder itself? There are those who believe, in fact, the Heidelberg Confession, I believe, says that if it happened, God did it. I think that's a heinous idea, by the way. But God did create everything that is, and he created a world in which there was the possibility of evil coming about, obviously, because this is the world we live in, and he created it. So in that ultimate sense, God is the creator. However, I think we have to look at it, perhaps even as we look at our children. I have two children, and I and Shelley, together with the power of God, created them in the schemes that God makes for creation. But I'm not fully responsible for all of their actions, good or bad, and because they're a free agent, so to speak, and they're out of my control to a certain degree and ability after a certain point in life. So did I create them? As the old Bill Cosby line said, I brought you into this world, I can take you out of this world, right? Well, I can't do that anymore. They're up and grown, and I have very little control over them. But I'm responsible, in a sense, for what they have done. Now, if they go out and perform evil, am I culpable for that? And can I be arrested for that? No, I can't be. It was not my action. So I think we have to put this in perspective here in that regard. It's a great question, Sharon. about did God create evil? And I think that the only question would be, well, if he didn't, who did? I think we can say Satan acted the evil, but God created Lucifer, who became Satan. So it does go back. Now some would say, oh, God should not have done that. And God should know better. Well, of course, we're the ones to tell God how he should know better, right? And yet, I think we're asking for the impossible there, or we're asking for something we don't want. We can have an inanimate world in which evil is not a possibility, or we can have a robotic world in which evil is not a possibility. But we would also not be created in the image of God. So you cannot be created with free will and not have any free will. So if we want a world in which there is truly the ability to make a decision, to love, to hate, which goes along with it, you've got to take this whole package. So I think we ought to say to God, God bless you for being, if I can put it this way, and it certainly demeans God to bring him down to this level, but for being man enough to create a world in which you were putting yourself and your reputation at risk in order that you also could be glorified when your creation chooses you, and you could be loved and provided for in terms of our fellowship and the glory that we can give. I think we've got to have this. So we want free will and we want no evil. Those two things don't go together. So sometimes people blame God. God created evil. He should have made the square a circle. He should make a square circle. Now think about that for a moment. You cannot make a square circle. That is an impossibility, to make a square circle or a circle square. You've got one or the other. They are mutually exclusive. So did God create evil? He created a world in which there was in the garden a tree that he created, which was the knowledge of good and good. No, it wasn't the knowledge of good and good. It was the knowledge of good and evil. So into this creation, somehow God created the possibility that as things flow along, there is going to be the possibility, or even the likelihood, or even the certainty that evil is going to come along. And it's just part and parcel of the way that creation is. But I wouldn't want to take it away and say, God, you shouldn't have done that. God, you should have created robots. I would rather be a robot. I would rather be a robot. I would rather not have any ability to think for myself. I would rather God open my brain and put in all the words, I love you, God. I lift you up. You are wonderful. Now, what kind of praise would that be? It wouldn't be praise at all. It would be silliness. It would be ridiculous. It would not be the world that God would look down upon and say, that is very good. We've tarnished it. We've messed it up. And God punishes for that. And Satan, who is at the beginning of messing it up, is the one that God created for him, a lake of fire that he will go into. And, of course, those who end up following him will go in there as well. So, great question, of course, taking that off the cuff a little bit. Hopefully, I've answered that correctly. You questioned those assumptions. Thank you, Sharon, for sending that question in.